And welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Let's Play Splinter Cell. And let's continue mission 9. And see if I can play this game a bit better. Last time, some good old-fashioned screwing up. Medical kit, thank you. Nothing. So up the stairs. Still got some toys left. Thankfully. So much for the easy start. Got a stick. Still encrypted. Wonder if I can knock them out while they're asleep. Ohoya. That's all I can say. I guess stealth isn't my strong suit. But on we go. Let's soldier on.
We'll be pulling out soon. Relocate your patrol to the main hall.
Sorry there, had to kite the mic for a moment. Inuki is started to bark. Those who haven't watched my Onimusha videos, Inuki is my Japanese Akira. Oh no. I hope I didn't fumble this already. One moment, ladies and gentlemen, and we're back. Really annoying puzzle. A turret. Thank you. More gibberish.
Have an official order for this.
There's no time. I have to see the convoy before it leaves.
I understand, but this is the only time.
Come on, you didn't see anything.
Maybe I should have been shot.
Phew! He didn't see the body.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
If I screw this up... Why, Fisher? Okay. Now I'm officially the worst Splinter Cell player in history. One moment, ladies and gentlemen. Why didn't you land it stealthily? Well, at least now I have... I don't know what to say anymore. I mean, I just don't get it. That why every time when Fisher jumps the pipe, he automatically, when I let go, he doesn't go to crouch. Do I have to press the crouch button before he falls? Or why? At least I didn't die this time, but I still lost some health. And I lost that one earring. Things just seem to go.
You can't hide.
Things just seem to go bad to worst for me. Is there anything else? All that for just data intel? Can I go out the window? Thank you. Because if that had been only for intel, I might have started crying. So, when we come back, ladies and gentlemen, this epic bumbling show will continue on. Until then, I'll see you when I see you. Later!